I'm in primary school.
My name is Colin. Say it is a primary to all about I'm in primary school.
This lesson is calculus, chapter 5,
indefinite integral.
Remember our indefinite integral. What have we learned?
We learned 7 basic formulas.
Partial fraction.
Partial fraction. Integral by parts. Last but not least, the last one, which is substitution.
Yes, correct, substitution. So in total, we have these 4, right?
Yep.
So for this question, can we try our knowledge?
Yeah. We are going to use 3 methods. 2 methods are half angle formula. And the last method, which is complex variables. So actually, one is for sine, one is for cosine.
This question is?
The question is integral sine squared x cosine to the power of 4x dx. Continue.
Okay, so remember for this we will need to find the sine squared x. So we find sine squared x and cosine squared x. Using this double angle or half angle formula.
Also use the sine.
Is this a square or is it a 2?
Square.
It's a 2. Because here, right?
So it should be a 2, right?
Yes, not a square. Like this. Here, how many twos?
Three twos.
So there's an 8, right?
Definitely,
yes. Can we combine one of this with one of this?
Yep.
Then what do we have? Can we expand again?
Yep.
Then we can integrate, right?
Yes.
But some parts we still cannot integrate.
So we need to use either one of these.
Correct?
Correct.
So for this, what do we have? Cosine square.
Cosine square.
What shall we use?
We can use the this.
Then what can we have? Okay, cosine square. It can be done. This part?
Yes. So actually, we use this.
We can put this in, right?
Correct.
So here we'll need to change.
Yep. We haven't used this, right?
Okay, well, for this part, here, this one, what happens? Just an X, right?
Yes.
You'll need to change?
Of course.
Is it right like this? This.
Okay, so actually it should be a 4.
Then we can have 4 here.
Oh, this tell me something again.
So these two will cancel. And for this, which is what you're writing, there will be a 2x. And remember, the 3 over 4 times you can simplify.
Okay, so now we'll cancel some of these. We can?
Well, which is actually called simplify.
Yes.
Like this?
Yes.
And remember, using this formula, which we actually can separate this, right?
Yep.
We can sub it in?
Of course.
So when we separate that, we'll have a 3 over 4 sine x, right?
Yep.
So here times 3 over 4, simplify.
Yes.
Then after that, we have the 1/4 sine 3x.
Yeah.
Here, times 1/4. Then the sine 3 of this. Right?
Yeah.
So this is our answer.
Wait, actually, what we used just now is this formula, okay?
Yes.
So this is the correct answer. Actually,
right,
this also can be a set, but you just need to change this.
Okay, yes, and remember for this answer is all three methods at large we should be getting, right?
Yes.
So is it clear for this first method?
Yes, let's summarize for the first method.
So first, for this first method, we have used the number and half and row formula to find the sine square x, right? Then we can sum it in, right?
Yep.
After we sum in, we just take out this coefficient, then the binomial expansion.
Yes.
Again, binomial expansion, integration. We sum in the double or half and row formula again, right?
Correct.
Then this, we use the sine square x plus cosine square x equals 1.
Wait, where? There's no binomial expansion.
Here. Expansion. It can also be called a binomial expansion, right?
Okay. Wait, can?
Okay, well, next. So what could we use this time?
We could use these again.
First, we can have a sine square x, cosine square x, right? Which is from this part. And it will be, first we have a 1 over 4 over here, correct?
Correct.
So we have a sine square 2x.
Yes.
then the cosine squared x, which will be the?
Because it must be one of the cosine, right? But which? It would most likely be the what? This.
So we have this again. We have this, right?
Right.
Well, what can we continue?
How?
Put it from 10?
Yes.
Expand?
Yep.
Then for this part, what can we have for the sine square?
For the sine square, we could have
this, right?
Double angle formula.
Yes, correct. Double angle formula.
So we will use this. Well, that means for the second method, we also use.
Okay, here we can put cosine in.
Yes.
Then after that, we can separate this end. Integrate, right?
Integrate.
Correct?
Yes.
Then we can sub in the sine qx formula.
Yes, thus.
So when we sub it in 3 over 4 times, this part will be, okay, we simplify, right?
Yes.
Then the sine x, which is this part?
Yes.
Here, times of 1 quarter. Well, first we can write this down, right?
Of course.
Then what can we have?
After that, we could have...
Remember, 3 of this. So is it like this? The sine 6x, right?
Yes.
Okay, so here, this is our answer. Is it right?
Yes.
Okay, check.
Same,
yes.
Same.
So did you realize for this, we have the double half angle for the sine and this cosine?
Cosine.
Right? The cosine square x, right?
Yep. Now
okay.
We'll move on to the third.
Then for this part, we expand.
Yes.
After we expand here, we sub in the double or half angle formula, right?
Yes, double or half.
This part we put the cosine inside. Integrate sum in the sine cube x formula.
Yes.
Okay, so are you clear for this method?
Yep.
Okay, so can we erase this?
Of course.
Next method, we have the complex variables, right?
Yes.
For this complex variables method, let me first write out this question.
Yes.
What can we have for this?
We could have...
Could we just have a z?
Yes.
Z.
E to the power of ix.
You said it's e to the power of ix, right?
How about z?
What if it is like this?
So it will be e to the power of ix plus e to the power of negative ix. There goes.
Where's your n?
It's the n because it's to the power of n.
Yes. Then what can we get?
Yes.
Do you still remember what is cosine x?
It is e to the power of ix plus e to the power of negative ix over 2. So that means that was 2 cosine and x.
Correct?
Yes. What about for sine? Yes.
Then we can have this.
Okay.
2i.
Just write your I properly next time.
Correct?
Yep.
So for this part, what can we have?
We could have...
First, we use this, right?
Wait. Yes. We use this.
We sub it for this sine square x, right? Then
yes.
We will expand.
Yes.
And separate.
Right.
Is it right like this?
Yes.
Then, this cosine to the power of 4x, which one do we use?
We will use...
this part, right?
Yes.
So, we can have?
So, we could have...
Is there 1 over 8 here?
Yes.
Is there 1 over 8 or is there 1 over 16? Remember, there are 4 of the 2's.
So it's 16.
Then we can have integral. Actually, we don't need to separate this, right? But we also can. So for this cosine to the power of 4x, what do you think would it be? I could get it from here, correct?
Yes.
So actually for that, what do I just need to use?
You need need to use
correct?
Yep.
Then here, what do we have? Okay, we use the binomial expansion. Am I right? So
yes.
Here, write out the formula for the binomial expansion. Extra D and extra S. Close out the gap. All the way until yes. Okay, so I'm sure that that's the formula.
Yes.
Next up, we can use the binomial expansion.
Yes.
Right?
Right.
So we can combine those parts that can be combined, right?
Yes.
Which we use this part. Am I right?
Right.
So these two, it will be?
Those two? Those two, easy. Remember, you can change it to the button, the sine and cosine button. There's someone that is very lonely, and don't forget, it's an A.
Wait.
Yes.
Because that is an extra 4.
Yep. If here don't have a 4, then you are correct. The 6 is so lonely. The 10 is also so lonely. Don't 6:30.
Correct?
Yes.
Then, what can we have? Can we just integrate already?
Yeah.
Or do we combine first? Which one?
We could.
What do you want me to have? Integrate or combine?
Combine.
Okay, you want me to combine. So each of these, they will have to times 4.
Wait.
Or maybe I could integrate first, okay? Because I already separated these.
Okay. You at first shouldn't even separate it. Since you make a choice, so it's your choice.
So here times in, we have that. Here will be a 1 over 8, right?
Yes.
So 1 over 8 and the 1 over 4.
Yep.
Here is 1 over 2, right?
Yes.
1 over 4, am I right?
Yep.
So 6 over 16 is actually a 3 over 8, right?
Yes.
Therefore this times in, so it will be a 1 over 32. 1 over 32 times this, 1 over 6.
Yes.
Which is a 192, right?
Of course.
Then this times in, which is a 12 over 64, it will be a 3 over 16, right?
Yes.
3 over 16. And don't forget that here's an extra 4, right?
Of course.
Then the 30 over 64, which will have. Okay, which is actually a 15 over 32, right?
Yes.
Which is actually a 15 over 64 because of this extra 2.
Okay.
So 20 over 64 is 5 over 16.
Yep. So this is this.
This and this come together, which will become a. Actually, it's a 1 over 64, right? 1 over 64 is sine 4x. And remember, it's a negative. Can we start with the x first?
Okay, starting with x. Here x, that's for x. X here, x there. Now we'll look at 2x.
Wait.
Okay, after you write, you need it
like this, is it right?
Yes.
Then assign 2x. Yes. And the sine for x. Then finally for this lonely one.
Yes. How lonely?
Like this, is it right?
Yes.
So do we get the correct answer?
Of course.
You see, for these methods, first let's see what did we use here, okay? First, the sine square x.
Is the answer the same?
I already checked. Sine square x, which is sine square x plus cosine square x equals 1. We first use that, right?
Yep.
Expand and then I separate.
Yes.
Then after that, this cosine change into the z plus 1 over z, right?
Of course.
Then binomial expansion.
Correcto. Yep.
After that, we can actually regroup and then sum it back, right?
Yes, sum it back. If not, we don't know what is z. We must sum it back to know oh, that z is whatever x.
After that, we can integrate and then regroup them, right?
Yep.
Okay, so are you clear for all these methods in this lesson?
Yes, and what you want to say?
If you like our videos, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. So can we end our lesson here?
Yeah, next time we'll continue all these.
Fine. Okay, so see you in the next lesson.
Okay.
Thank you for your watching.